I'm Dr. Charles Apoki. I'm keeping to my promise to video to bring videos from all the houses. This is only house I'm approaching. Dr. Jessa, all the way from Australia, my classmate in medical school, personally requested that I should video record only house. So, Dr. Emma Jessa, this is only house. The lawns are still greenish. They will need to be trimmed. I was just discussing with the person who came with me. It will not cost too much to buy a lawnmower for each house. The gutters and the drainages are so badly kept. It won't take so much money to set blocks and do them very well. The floor here is also terrazzo. Maybe terrazzo was raining when these houses were built. The bathrooms are virtually the same. They can be maintained, the tiles can be removed, and newer tiles put. So that one of the things that impressed me, as I said earlier on, in one of my posts, that I used showers for the first time. The environment children live in affect their sense of decency. So these walls are cracking. They need to be amended. It's a sign of our attitude towards construction in Nigeria. Only house, here I am. I remember my senior, Edward Oli. They called him the Black Cat. Wonderful school goalkeeper. Only house, here is your house. And there are double bunks strewn all over the place. The windows, the aluminium windows they put, they've been destroyed. I think there is a nature of vandalism among this generation. We planted flowers, we painted our halls, we did general inspection, and we kept our environment clean. This generation, I wonder why they are very destructive. The house master system and the house prefect system needs to be reinvigorated if it is there, or restored if it is not there. And there has to be real discipline in the school. This oil bean tree, very big and it's still here. And then that's the border lane with those trees. I think I will just do Orerope House so that General Emiko will not send soldiers after me to arrest me. So this only house, this is your house. A lot needs to be done. The old boys are doing a lot. Government needs to do a lot. And then, like as we've done in Warri House, something needs to be done by those who stayed here when they were much younger. So my suggestion of aluminium windows, as good as it is, we must discipline our children so that they are not destructive. A lot of these windows were just broken deliberately. So, but this is still beautiful. With a little touch, we can restore the beauty of Ole House. I think that's the house master's house. One surprising thing about this school is that throughout my stay for 5 years, I never saw that house. I never went near there, either out of the fact that I had nothing much to do here, or you had a regimented lifestyle. And some of us, we dreaded the bullying earlier on, so we learned to keep to our territory and our comfort zone. You see, this tree is old, is dying. There must be a deliberate attempt to tactfully bring it down. If the root is still strong, they should cut off the branches from up so that it will not fall on the building or fall on human beings. Two solid soakaway pits are here that will still need maintenance. They need maintenance. The maintenance culture in Africa is a terrible problem, particularly Nigeria. So Ole House, beautiful house, still solid, with a little touch of care and discipline among our students, it will be restored to its original glory. So, Dr. Jessa, I've fulfilled my promise. All the way from Australia, you can show to your children that you attended a good school. When I was in Australia in 2015, I saw some of their schools that looked like our own. We can still maintain our own to be as beautiful as their own. Those are the solar panels. I'm your friend, Dr. Charles Apoki.